Thank you. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon, everybody. You're all very welcome as we gather once again to celebrate Mass, the sacred mysteries of the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus. And into that mystery we link the life of Mike and Keneally, and we pray for the happy repose of his soul, that he is safely at home with his God. I want to welcome his family, welcome all of you, people who are outside. I extend a warm welcome to the members of the family who are away in the United States, his brother Andrew and Marky and Annie, and those who are joining us and who are with us here in spirit. I welcome Josie and Eddie and all his nieces and nephews gathered here. We remember too Mikey's parents, Peter and Mary Keneally of Bunnell. We remember his siblings, sisters and brothers who are gone ahead of him, Peter and John, Martin and Matty, and also Bridget and Mary. We're entering into that great mystery of life that we don't reflect on an awful lot, perhaps. On a moment like this, we can't escape it. So we take a moment to reflect on the gift of life that God has given to each one of us, and that one day he will call us home again, and that we are praying for those who have gone on their way, and we're giving thanks to God for the wonderful long life that was given to Mikey Keneally, and the memories he has left, the friends he has made, and the family who love him. Grant him, Lord, eternal rest, and let perpetual life now shine on him forever. May he rest in peace. So we pause ourselves to prepare to celebrate Mass, to enter into the great celebration of the extraordinary mystery of Jesus' own life and death. And we do so by asking his pardon and mercy for any way in which we have failed. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit, Lord of mercy. You bring pardon and peace to the sinner, Christ of mercy. You bring light to those in darkness, Lord of mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who are the mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant Michael Keneally, for whom we perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness that you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, he may come before your face through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
So you may be seated now. We listen to God's word, which will be spoken to us by members of the family.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will prepare for all peoples a banquet of rich food. On this mountain, he will remove the mourning veil covering all peoples and the shroud enwrapping all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. He will take away his people's shame everywhere on earth, for the Lord has said so. That day it will be said, see, this is our God in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped. We exult and we rejoice that he has saved us. This is the word of the Lord.
The Lord's my shepherd, I not want.
to the Philippians. For us, our homeland is in heaven, and from heaven comes the Savior we are waiting for, the Lord Jesus Christ. And he will transfigure these wretched body of ours into copies of his glorious body. He will do that by the same power with which he can subdue the whole universe. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Said to his disciples, the hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Truly, truly, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains a single grain, but if it dies, it yields a rich harvest. Anyone who loves his life loses it, and anyone who hates his life in this world will keep it for the eternal life. If a person serves me, he must follow me. And where I am, there shall my servant be too. If anyone serves me, my Father will honor him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to God.
Over the last few days, like many of you perhaps, I've been watching on TV and in the papers the celebrations of our centenary of our civil war and its leaders. And aside from the sadness of the story of our civil war, what took my interest was the depiction and the images of Ireland 100 years ago. Cycling, telegrams sent across the country, took ages for messages to be delivered, communication, travel, everything was so slow and so very different to the world we knew in 1922. Into that world, a few years later in 1925, Mikey Keneally was born. Different in so many ways, like every other family of the time, he was born into a big family of 11 siblings. At a time in Ireland that we know was a struggle, not just politically, but a struggle to survive. And so you look back with awe and, if you like, admiration for the extraordinary way in which everybody sought out and began to make a life for themselves, and many travelled, and many headed for England and the United States. And so that's the story of Mike Keneally's life as well. A short time in the mines in Tipperary, then he went to England as a construction worker. And for 60 years, he worked hard. You can only begin to imagine, up and down the length and breadth of England and Scotland, all the different building sites, all the different Monday mornings work, meeting new people, moving from one building site to another, that in a sense he must have known the UK up and down. And in all of that time, while Mikey was a single man, he was blessed to be part of family life, living beside his brother Joseph, living beside nieces and nephews, sharing the warmth of a family life and offering his own wisdom and love and creating memories. I say 60 years is a long time. It's a lifetime, really. And so Mikey returned back to his native soil and lived in Forgloss along the shore, just across the shoreline from his home house in Bunnahall. It must be a huge, I suppose, delight for him to discover the smell of the sea and the seaweed, to hear again the sounds of nature, and to cycle as he did all his life, cycle it to and from, to get to know, reconnect again with family and nephews and nieces and neighbours, to become part of a life that he once knew. And I'm very conscious, as I become aware, that over his long life of 97 years, the extraordinary changes in society, that the one thing that remained completely constant for Michael Keneally was his faith. I'm told that in the middle, as a young man, working hard, every single weekend he dressed up and went to the cathedral in Manchester, to the church, to worship his God, like he learned it at the heart of his parents in the heart stone in Bonham. And that equally, as an older man in his 80s, he would cycle from Foreglass into Clifton to go to Mass, to do his shopping. Such was the faith, and that faith he recognised for him, as it does for anyone who believes, was, if you like, an anchor in his life, something he held onto, something that was very precious. Something in his dying days, when I saw him in the hospital, and I knew from the nurse when she offered to say the rosary with him, he took the beads, and he knew well it was a familiar prayer, it wasn't strange. And equally, when he came to anoint him, he was aware of the God that had carried him all those years, the God to whom he was about to return. So today, as we come to honour his life, it's, if you like every day, in some way challenges us to look at our own lives. It taps into our own mortality, that we recognise that we too are on that same journey. And the gospel story message is always interesting and significant. And for us who live along and live on the farm and pass by farms every day, know what it's like to hear life being described as a seed that goes into the ground. And that, like Mike, you would have known, every spring and every winter we saw death and decay, new life and then death and new life again. The springtimes and the winters in his life. Today we celebrate his going home into an eternal springtime where life will be, if you like, perpetual. Perpetual life will shine on him. He'll have perfect peace and he'll be at home with his God and Maker. So I'd like, on behalf of the community, to extend to his brothers and sisters in the United States who are joining us and who must be filled with memories of here in Ballyconeely, their own growing up, like his brothers here, Eddie and Josie, and all of you, his nieces and nephews, who will have fond memories of him, to extend to you on behalf of the community our deepest sympathy. Eryeshje Garay Lahanam Usir. We might stand now to make our prayers, and those who are making the prayers, the faithful, might please come forward and offer prayers for Mikey and on our behalf.
We pray for the staff of Clifton Hospital who looked after Mikey. We also pray for Father and Anne and the doctors John and Jamie Casey who cared for Mikey over the years. Lord, gracious.
Lord, gracious.
Pray for Mickey, his father and mother, his deceased brothers and sisters, and all the deceased members of his family. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious.
We pray for Angela and Joseph, who cared for him in his later years. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious.
We include in our prayers today Thomas Keneally of Ellis Lannan, whose funeral will be taking place tomorrow. We remember all who have died, our loved ones who have journeyed ahead of us. We pray for their safe homecoming into their eternal home. And we pray for all families, like the needy families who are grieving the loss and the pain of a loved one. Grant, Lord, strength, comfort, consolation, and hope into their lives again. Lord, hear us. We pause for a moment to bring our own personal prayer, whatever it is, in the silence of your own heart, your memories, your thoughts. We bring it to the Lord in silence. Lord, hear us. God, our Father, you called each one of us into life. You gifted us with so many unique, different talents and life. You asked us to help you build your kingdom on earth by the way we live, simply truthful, honest, kind, loving and forgiving. Help us as we journey through life to be honor our task that you have given us and welcome safely home Mikey, who has fought the good fight, who has finished the race, who has kept the faith, and now awaits the crown of glory through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Might be seated now, and some gifts representing Mickey's life and the bread and wine offered in the Mass will be carried to the altar by family members.
Mickey's grandnephew, Michael, is bringing up his playing cards to represent how he enjoys to play the card game Patience. His nephew, Joe, is carrying his betting slips as he likes to back the horses. His nephew, Gerard, is carrying a picture of him and Mickey that was taken on a day out fishing. His nephew Kevin is carrying a newspaper cutting taken from the Irish News of Mickey cycling his bike on the road outside his house. And finally, his brother Joseph and sister-in-law Angela are bringing forward the bread and wine.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, and human hands have made, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God,
by the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, that will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Wash away my iniquity, Lord. Cleanse me from all my sins. Pray, my friends, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Michael Keneally, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stray stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just. It is our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For even though by our fault we perish, yet by your compassion and your grace, we are redeemed through the Christ's great victory, and with him we are called back into life. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. evil comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and to make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, the pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said a blessing, and broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ has risen, Christ will come again. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all the saints and whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, our Bishop Francis, and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Michael Keneally, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. So let us stand together and turn to our Heavenly Father. Pray the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Kingdom and the power and the glory of us now and ever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. An occasion of a funeral is always a sad occasion. It disturbs our comfort and stirs up memories, and so we welcome the gift of peace, that the Lord would bring peace into our hearts in a way that nothing else can. So let us welcome his offer to us of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us. This is Jesus, the Son of God and the Son of Mary, who came into the world to show us the way, who became man, who suffered, who died, and who rose again, that we might have new life. This is the Lamb of God, who carries our burdens, takes away our sins, and happy are we who are invited to share in his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Micah, who has journeyed today from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. Amen. In a few moments' time, we would have the blessing of the remains, a very beautiful part of the funeral liturgy, is the sprinkling with holy water, a reminder of our baptism, of being joined into the mystery of Jesus' death and resurrection, and then the incense is a reminder that the body is the sacred temple that carries the soul. And as you may be aware, over the last 2 years, because of COVID, and we're holding on for another while to the custom of having communion at the very end of Mass, and people, I'll be asking the immediate family to stay here and everybody else to come up and exit the side door here or down by the side and receive communion if you wish, and then wait outside to welcome the remains as it will be led out by the members of the family. And so before that, I think Mary, isn't it? Who's going to say a few words? Is there somebody to say a few words? No, that's okay. I think Michael's life has spoken words in itself. So I'd like to honour that. And somebody mentioned to me last night that there's 90 years between himself and his youngest grandnephew, great-grandnephew, Michael. So 90 years is a wonderful span of life. So we thank God for the memories. I would thank God for their great faith and their courage, all the family members, and indeed all our family members. An occasion like this, for me anyway, brings to mind the extraordinary resilience of our people, those who have gone before us, lived a very different lifestyle, worked hard, and had a strong, strong faith. Ivai Elegeji Anarive. So let us stand now for the final prayers of commendation. Trusting in God, we have prayed for Mikey, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we should see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Response to our prayer is, receive his soul and present him to God the Most High.
Receive his soul and present him to God.
Saints of God, come to his aid, hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Receive his soul and present him to God.
May Christ who called you take you to himself, and may angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul and present him to God.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine on him forever. Eternal rest into your hands, Heavenly Father of mercies. We commend our brother Mikey in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Amen. So I'm going to invite the family now to be seated, if everybody else would come forward to exit from the front and to receive communion.
There were peace.